Pocono Raceway. Friday morning, Mike Mullen from MikeMullen.net. Halfway through the regular season, and we're going to the front door this time. Take the back road on Sunday morning. Right now, we're going to see what kind of crowd we got coming up here. 90 miles from New York City. Closest NASCAR place to the big town. See if they can draw some fans over from that part of the world. And we're also looking to see if Tony Stewart can get on track. He was hot here last year, won the race. He was hot last spring. This spring, don't know what's going on over there. Ryan Newman finally perked up a little bit last week at Charlotte. Right now, June, a lot of jobs are on the line. Sponsorships are on the line. We're watching Budweiser, UPS, a couple of others. See what's going to happen and see if Richard Childress comes up with a fourth team. I'm hearing that he's looking for one. Hey, we're waiting to see what Rick Hendrick's going to do. There's five drivers. He's got five drivers under contract. Casey Kane's the new guy. Is there an odd man out? NASCAR says you can only have four teams. Wonder what that means for Casey. Wonder what that means for Mark Martin. Hearing that there are a lot of things that Mark Martin might have up his sleeve, and I think Jeff Burton might be part of the deal. He talked about Jeff Burton being his agent on some of these things. Maybe Jeff wants to get Mark over to the Richard Childress camp. Childress has three teams, and he's got room for a fourth. So what does that mean? Is he going to have a fourth team next year? Can he find a sponsor? Hey, the way Mark Martin drove at Charlotte, I think they might be able to pull something together. But Mark says he's where he's at next year. Alan Gustafson, we'll see if that happens. We'll see where they put Casey Kane. See if Tony Stewart can win again. And, of course, we got the Busch brothers, Kyle and Kurt. And I tell you, Kurt's making Roger Penske look brilliant. I tell you, the way they ran at Charlotte, took the All-Star, took the 600, had to fend off younger brother Kyle, though, to win. Kyle, Denny Hamlin, good picks here. Tony Stewart's a little off his game, and Jimmy Johnson and Jeff Gordon really seem off their game. I don't know what's going on with them the last couple of weeks. They just seem to be off kilter. Got plenty of power and everything. Don't know if they've got problems or if they've just got a run of bad luck coming. So with all the good luck they've had lately, it's about time for some of that stuff to turn around. And what to say about the Childress guys? Kevin Harvick, won at Talladega, needs a sponsor. Didn't look too bad the month of May, actually. He says that's his worst month, some of his worst tracks, and now he's coming to some good tracks. Can Kevin Harvick doing something here? Pocono? Maybe so. I think the Jeff Burton ought to do good here. The Joe Gibbs guys are looking pretty sharp. And if I were you, I'd keep an eye on Joey Logano. I'm thinking Joey Logano is going to be winning something here before long. He's been looking awful impressive, and so are his teammates. His teammates are looking really, really tough. Kurt has to have his hands full trying to keep track of Kyle and Denny Hamlin. Can Kurt do something up here? Kurt Busch. Can Kyle Busch do something up here? What about Denny Hamlin? This is one of his best tracks. This is where he really launched his career. Maybe so. I'm not sure. Maybe something strange is going to happen. We've got a lot of drivers that need to make things happen, like David Ragan, Carl Edwards. Can he make the chase? Are they just looking to make the chase? What about Greg Biffle? Fast? Can he do something up here? And what about Matt Kenseth? Now, if you're looking for somebody who knows how to play the game and win, it's Matt Kenseth. But he seemed awful depressed at Dover and awful depressed at Charlotte, even though he ran well. Just not enough speed. Carl Edwards says the cars just don't seem to turn well in the corner. Well, about time to get some of that stuff fixed, I think. This is going to be a long day on Sunday. 500 miles of Pocono? Jeff Gordon's not the only one that says it ought to be shorter. Well, the way I'm hearing it from the Weather Channel, it is going to be shorter on Sunday because it's going to rain on Saturday and Sunday. But the weatherman's not always right. But then this is Pocono, and it nearly always rains up here. In fact, it's supposed to start raining this afternoon. I don't know. Will we get in qualifying? Will we be around till Monday like we've been before? Or will it just blow through? Be interesting to see. Pocono Raceway. And it's Friday morning. Mike Mullen from MikeMullen.net. Qualifying. A lot of things going to go on today. I hope. If the clouds blow away and we get something going. Tony Stewart. I'm looking for Tony Stewart to make something happen today. He's been in such a funky mood, and he needs something to really pump things up for that Eldora racetrack that he's got going on. The prelude to the dream next Wednesday night for all the Sprint Cup drivers. Let's see what he can do. Mike Mullen from MikeMullen.net, heading in to Pocono Raceway to see what Tony Stewart and the guys can do. Friday morning. Mike Mulhern from MikeMulhern.net.